Here's how I use three-act math in my classroom, a style of lesson that I learned from Dan Meyer through his blog and his Twitter account. The three acts involve setting up the problem, solving the problem, and revealing the answer to your students. Act 1, setting up the problem. I present students with an image, and I ask them, what do you notice? So in this case, what do you notice about the lamppost and the person? Here are some of the examples of things my students noticed. They may have noticed that the lamppost is taller than the person. They may have also noticed that both the lamppost and the person have created shadows on the ground. Next, I ask my students, what do you wonder about the lamppost and the person? Questions that my students wondered are things like, how tall is the lamppost? Or, how many people can I stack on top of each other to equal the height of the lamppost? Next, I ask my students to estimate the height of the lamppost in meters. I actually ask them to estimate 3 times, estimating too high, too low, and then their best estimate. My last class to do this activity had a minimum guess of 10 meters tall, a maximum guess, somebody guessed 50 meters tall, and the class average was around 16 meters tall for the lamppost. For this problem, I also added in a question about which distances we could physically measure and which ones we couldn't. My students put red stars on the distances they thought we could physically measure. We had a class discussion about whether or not we could reach the top of the lamppost with a ruler, as well as if we could measure from the top of the lamppost through the air to the tip of the shadow. You'll see here that my students did not necessarily adjust their answers after our class discussion. Act 2, collecting data and solving the problem. I provided each group of students with a paper copy of this image for them to record their measurements. As a class, we went outside and students measured any of the distances they needed in order to solve this problem. Students brought meter sticks and recorded their measurements on the handout. Once back inside, each group has a section of blackboard or whiteboard to work on. Students solved the problem with their partners in groups of 3. Act 3, revealing the answer and reflecting on the process. As the teacher, I facilitate a debrief of the different groups' solutions. We go from board to board and talk about their solution strategies as well as any misconceptions that might have come up as they solved. We used a weighted string thrown over the top of the lamppost in order to measure the length of the string and find the actual height of the lamppost from top to bottom. At this point, we look back to the student's estimates from the beginning of the problem and we celebrate the student that had the closest guess. Also, this is a great time to talk about reasons why the math we did may not have come out with the same answer as the actual height of the lamppost. To recap, 3-act math. Act 1, setting up the problem. Act 2, collecting data and solving. Act 3, revealing the answer and debriefing our solution methods. I'd love to hear about your experiences using 3-act math in your classroom. Get in touch on Twitter. I hope to hear from you soon.